I know, I talk about heat pumps a lot, but there's a good reason for it. It's a fantastic technology that uses a little physics exploit to get more heat energy out than the energy that you put in. The problem is that most of the time, the devices I'm talking about are for homeowners that can easily retrofit new installations into place, or in my case, drill a massive ground loop well for a geothermal system. That's definitely out of reach for most. So where does this leave renters? Well, there's a new type of heat pump hitting the market that's a little more accessible. Easy to install heat pumps that sit on your window just like an AC unit. It seems so obvious when you look at it that I can't help but wonder, why didn't we do this earlier? And how well do they actually work and at what cost? I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. This video is brought to you by CCAN Action Fund, but more on that later. I'm sure a lot of you have been stuck in situations where you're at the mercy of an antiquated heating and cooling system. For example, how do you adapt to an apartment building that's 100 years old and heated with a gas steam boiler system that you have no control over? It's heating to the lowest common denominator, which means some apartments are cozy and others are cooking. In a situation like that, sometimes the only available option is to crack windows open in the dead of winter. Not a great way to conserve energy and save money. Now, this is a pretty common problem in many older buildings in US cities like New York and Boston. I know, because I lived in a unit just like it. It's through window heat pumps that New York City is leading by example when it comes to heat pump adoption in the United States. In accordance with the city's Local Law 97 of 2019, buildings in the Big Apple are now required to make massive cuts in greenhouse gas emissions over the next few decades. The goal is to reduce emissions by 40% by 2030 and by 80% by 2050. Now, to hit that target, the New York City Housing Authority, or the NYCHA, is focused on improving heating and cooling systems within the public housing network. This means landlords need to start upgrading antiquated and inefficient boiler systems in public housing across the city, which affects more than 500,000 people in over 2,400 buildings. Radiant systems and steam-based boilers, while fairly efficient, are not as efficient as heat pumps. Large steam systems are complex, prone to energy leaks, and only about a third of their input energy is converted into useful heat. And that's where window heat pumps come into the picture. When I first saw reports of these, all I could do was this. You can see right off the bat what makes these designs unique. They're inverse U or saddle style design that doesn't obstruct the window's view. It's easy for residents to install it themselves in about half an hour or less without the need for a professional or wrecking existing structures. And the icing on the cake? No electrical upgrades needed. These heat pumps run off of a standard 120 volt AC outlet. I know, 120 volts, we're here in the US. This puts temperature control back into the hands of residents and makes it all more efficient thanks to the power of the heat pump. You can have your heat pump cake and eat it too. Now there's other convenient features that window heat pumps offer as well, like relatively smaller footprints, low noise levels, and condensation management systems. That means no excess water dripping down buildings or external hoses or trays. These also help to reincorporate humidity into dry air. And there are even some early anecdotal reports that they've literally helped residents breathe easier. A window heat pump's components won't be much of a shocker to those of you who are already familiar with traditional heat pumps, but here's the basics. It's got a compressor, a condenser, evaporator, and a reversing valve that allows it to switch between heating and cooling modes. These are all housed within one compact unit that fits within a window. Since heat pumps move heat rather than generate it from something like an electric resistive heating element, you'll get 2 to 3 times more heat energy out than the electrical energy that you put in. That's why in 2021, the New York Power Authority, the New York State Energy Research Development Authority, and the NYCHA launched the Clean Heat for All Challenge. This involved investing $263 million into advancing electrification efforts to meet New York's climate and energy goals. The idea was to promote designs that could slot into existing infrastructure and eliminate the high costs normally associated with rolling out heat pumps to apartments. So who ended up taking action and rising to the challenge? Well, before we get to that, there's another thing that you can take action on. Now, one of the best nonprofits fighting climate change just launched an annual electric vehicle raffle, and I want to tell you about it. Now, all proceeds go to the amazing Chesapeake Climate Action Network Action Fund. And here are 3 reasons why you should buy a raffle ticket right now. Number one, your odds of winning have never been better. For the first time, you have not one, but 2 chances to win a brand new electric vehicle with just 1 ticket. Number two, the prizes are amazing. The first place winner will choose from a Rivian SUV, a Rivian R1T truck, a Tesla Model X Plaid, or a Tesla Cybertruck. And the second place winner will get the amazing Hyundai Ioniq 5. And three, our friends at CCAN Action Fund do amazing work nationwide addressing the climate crisis. So you'll be supporting a great cause. To enter, visit evraffle.org. That's evraffle.org. Tickets are just $200 and only 7,000 will be sold. Your odds have never been better. Visit evraffle.org or check the description below. Thanks to CCAN Action Fund and to all of you for supporting the channel. So back to who took up the Clean Heat for All challenge. That would be Midea US, headquartered in New Jersey and Gradient based in San Francisco. As the winners of the challenge, Midea will provide 20,000 heat pump units to a NYCHA pilot project, while Gradient will supply 10,000 units. So let's look at Midea first. Midea's packaged window heat pump, or PWHP, not only represents the lion's share of the challenge winnings, but it also earned itself a prestigious AHR Expo Innovation Award this year. That's a convention held by the American Society of Heating, Refrigeration, and Air Conditioning Engineers. Now, the heat pump is specifically designed for DIY installation. As you can see here, the body has handles built into it to help easily slide the unit over the windowsill. The PWHP can provide 9,000 BTU per hour of heating and cooling. Then there's its coefficient of performance, or COP. And the COP is a measure of a heat pump's efficiency based on the unit's heating capacity versus the amount of electricity that it uses. It's basically just a ratio. It's a handy metric for comparing heat pumps against each other and other forms of heating. Now, Midea's heat pump has a COP of 2.35 at temperatures as low as 17 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 8 degrees Celsius. Now, for comparison, anything that burns fuel, like a furnace or a boiler, is going to have a COP of 1 or less. And the PWHP can operate at temperatures down to negative 13 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 25 degrees Celsius without auxiliary heat and all the way up to 113 degrees Fahrenheit or 45 degrees Celsius for cooling. That meaning that this unit should be able to easily handle those cold New York winter nights or hottest of summer days. On the flip side, we have the combined energy efficiency ratio, which measures the efficiency of a room or window-mounted AC unit. Midea's heat pump scores a 16, which puts it at or above the scores of most high-end window AC units on the market. Now let's look at Gradient, who are set to supply their own all-weather 120-volt window heat pump. The numbers on this heat pump will look pretty familiar to you. This window heat pump also has 9,000 BTUs of heating or cooling and an easy-to-install window-mounted frame. It maintains a COP of 2.6 at temperatures of 17 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 8 degrees Celsius and keeps functioning down to negative 7 degrees Fahrenheit or negative 21.7 degrees Celsius. Now, the high end of the range is 95 degrees Fahrenheit or 35 degrees Celsius, which should handle the typical temperature range of New York. Now, this heat pump also plugs into a standard wall outlet and is made with DIY installs in mind. Gradient claims that you can do it yourself in just 15 to 20 minutes. Now, Gradient has boasted about their use of R32 as a refrigerant. In the past, many refrigerants were pretty harmful to the environment or the ozone layer. But R32 scores a big fat zero in ozone depletion potential and has a global warming potential of around 675. That might sound a little rough at first, but that's actually close to one-third the GWP of more common refrigerants. Gradient's heat pump is efficient too. It has a combined energy efficiency ratio of 10.8, qualifying it for a coveted, but not uncommon, Energy Star Award. So for what it's worth, it seems like the Gradient heat pump is slightly more efficient at the mid-range of temperatures and is alleged to be quicker to install, but Midea's take on the window heat pump has better effective temperature range and a better combined energy efficiency ratio. But both look like great options. So what do these heat pumps mean for New Yorkers? Well, we've already covered a lot of the quality of life benefits that they offer to residents, but let's look at them versus older boiler technologies that these window units are trying to replace. Whether it's a gas or oil boiler, a condensing boiler, a steam boiler, it doesn't really matter because none of these older technologies are going to break a COP of 1. Even an electric radiator is going to score a COP of 1. So for energy efficiency, the window units win out. Things start to get fuzzier when it comes to the cost. Now, traditionally, the pricey nature of heat pumps has been their biggest stumbling block. Both companies have noted that they want to keep the cost affordable, and NYCHA wants to keep the cost below $3,000. Midea says their pump will cost $3,000 on the dot, while Gradient says their unit will be around $2,000, but their current model runs for $3,800. Now, for a comparison, a window-mounted AC unit only costs a few hundred dollars at the low end, but it can only cool your home. Now, these window heat pumps heat and cool, which AC units just can't do. They're also far more efficient than any tiny space heater systems that you can install. On top of that, they also use more eco-friendly refrigerants than many of the aging window AC units that apartments like this are probably using. But that's still a lot of money for all those benefits. Plus, there's always the chance that manufacturing or supply chain challenges could put the final market price even higher than the hoped-for price. Now, we've seen it happen with plenty of technologies before. On the other hand, heat pumps are generally eligible for rebates or tax deductions, like the Inflation Reduction Act here in the US. So that could help ameliorate things. Now, even with rebates and tax incentives, heat pumps are still likely to be a big upfront investment for a renter or landlord to recoup that cost slowly over time. This all makes the math of heat pumps versus retrofitting the old boiler systems pretty hard to calculate. Instead of getting a window heat pump for every resident, the owner of a large building could replace the old gas boiler with an industrial heat pump. That heat pump could feed hot fluid to radiators, underfloor heating, and the like. In these old buildings, though, you'd still run into the issue of heating to the lowest common denominator, which would undercut much of the energy efficiency gains. I'm having flashbacks to my Boston apartment again. It also doesn't address the need for cooling, which can be a major issue during summer heat waves in cities like New York and Boston. There's also an overall quality of life issue that these heat pumps can address that makes it hard to put a number on. And again, if you're not allowed to remodel part of a building because it's a historical landmark or due to mold and asbestos fears, then window-mounted units would be the way to go, regardless of the price. What I'm trying to say is, there's a lot of variables that you have to consider here. There's also concerns about electricity usage. In many apartment buildings, heat is included in your rent, but you pay for electricity yourself. Shifting to these window heat pumps means that renters will be taking their heating and cooling costs into their electric bill. That's an incentive for a landlord to make the switch because it reduces their cost for running the building, but the switch will hit the renter's bottom line. However, as a renter, you'll have complete control over how much you run the unit and at what temperature. Collectively, 30,000 heat pumps are going to draw a lot of electricity. The agencies involved don't think this will strain the grid, but if everything goes according to plan and window-mounted heat pumps take off, what will 3.64 million new heat pumps working night and day do to the grid? Probably not nothing. And while there are some concerns about strain on the grid, the efficiency of heat pumps means they're likely to be better than all the other climate control devices currently in use. Gradient estimates that the yearly energy cost of running their heat pump to be between $64 and $238. There's a lot of variables that go into that figure, so the exact price will vary a lot. However, that's still a good deal, especially compared to your average air conditioner, which will cost you between $172 and $2,534 per year. Now take those operational savings and spread it across not just New York, but other cities that are interested in similar bulk orders of these heat pumps, like Jersey City, Boston, and Seattle. Together, they represent almost 24,000 apartments. An estimated 39 million Americans in general live in apartments, and that number is only going to go up. America, of course, is not alone. Lots of cities like Tokyo, Toronto, and Beijing have apartment dwellers who could benefit from heat pumps just like this. While upfront cost may remain a speed bump, it won't surprise you to hear that I'm pretty bullish on these window-mounted variety. Again, I know I love heat pumps, but shrinking them down a bit and tooling them for smaller spaces like apartments just seems like a natural next step in their evolution. But what do you think? Would you want a unit like this for your home? Jump in the comments and let me know. And be sure to listen to my follow-up podcast, Still to Be Determined, where we'll keep this conversation going. Thanks as always to my patrons for your continued support. I'll see you in the next one.